in a black car out
in the summer. That's a beauty. With the whip hands and on the back. About his dad, you know, with Highway Patrol, the TV show that a lot of us watched in our youth. Really interesting. All right, this is the next class. World War II American manufacturer.
After I'm gone, after the breakup, after I'm gone.
This is a four-door convertible, and it's owned by Davis. 1936, for a lot of people that are in these ports, is considered one of the high waters. If you're familiar with the PT cruiser, that was really designed after the 1937, which for people that might lose their cars.
They did restyle cars almost every year.
Yeah. Well, you know, they take the deluxe year, and the next year they sell it as a standard. This is second place. This is a 1949 Chevrolet Skyline Deluxe, owned by Charles Hinkles. Now, I love this vintage red. Bruce Meyer had a Duesenberg beer that sent this red. And this is such a great color of red. You know, when they do these surveys, deep reds tend to be favored by females more than males, and males were more into the bright red, you know, in your face.
Well, if you remember, one of the American cars is called Hussy, and it was a Stephen Lynch.
Chrysler Airflow 2. John Larson is the owner. The Airflow, there was the Airflow DeSoto also, the Major Pose, who had a talent show. Like, this is a very swoopy Art Deco type car.
When I was in class,
I'm so happy to see the Japanese vintage cars. This is a vintage car, like you said, 40 years old. Included in a lot of the events like here at San Marino.
Absolutely. Here comes our second-class car. And these Honda cars, because previously Hondas were only motorcycles, so you had to clarify and say it's a Honda car. This is a 1970 Honda N600, owned by Tim Mink.
Well, Tim Means is a good friend of mine, and he is the premier restorer of these N600s. He found and restored the very first Honda that was brought into the U.S., and American Honda bought it from him, and it's now in the vault down at the Peterson.
That's awesome.
So it doesn't shock me to see his car up here.
Okay, here comes our first place car, rightly so, a 1968 Toyota 2000 GT, owned by Michael and Barbara Malamud of the Malamud Collection out in Newbury Park. And this is a car that had a lot of hands in it. Yamaha helped with the engine. Carroll Shelby actually raced these, or set up a racing team with these. A very collectible car these days.
Yeah, these cars, I was talking with Stuart Reed, who's the department chair of the Transportation Design Department at Art Center, College of Design, and They're just, this is an iconic design. You look at that crease line on the rear fender and all, these cars are beautiful. And they were a lot, they were very expensive compared to other cars at the time.
And they became very expensive as a
collectible. Yeah, very expensive, yeah.
All right, thank
selling,
you very much.
Selling well over $1 million. All right, our next class is European luxury. This is a 1955 Rolls-Royce Silver Dawn owned by Ernie Rullis. And, you know, you don't see a lot of white Rolls, right? I mean, black is like the color.
When you see them from the higher out wedding cars.
Yes.
You know, you have a special wedding and they like the white ones. You know, the bride is in white, looks pretty elegant. So, wedding car is interesting.
You know, you remember John Lennon got the Rolls and had it painted psychedelic, and of course Rolls said,
"Ernie, you're interviewing my son at the castle."
Yeah.
Second place, the 1971 Volvo 1800E, owned by Sue Matz, and this is the same car.
Yeah, Roger Moore.
And I love this color. I mean, you got that color. Would look good on a lot of cars today.
Well, this is also Volvo was trying to, they could have some flair. You know,
right.
Some really stylish car. I think the early ones were even built in England before they moved production to Sweden. But a very breathtaking design that eventually evolved into the ES.
Yeah, look at how the trim line goes back into the rear tail light, how it comes out. I mean, that's used to the ES. Yeah, our first place car is a 1972. Is that right? Volvo 1800E, it's owned by Tom Carlisle. So here we go again. And
this one seems to be equipped with more of a stock type wheel. The other one had a sport
type. Yeah, I like them both. Yeah. I'm a little bit more of the mag look myself. But this is really, again, this is an interesting color. Both of them are really, really unique colors, which is great to see.
Thank you very much. All right, our next category is who got the Mama 49. Our second place is a 1965 Volkswagen Type C dual cab pickup owned by Lisa and Mark Henzo. And they used to call this a Doka. They have a lot of different names for these. But if you find these, in fact, Pasadena Volkswagen has one of their booths.
And check out that air conditioning system there with those front windows. I owned a 58 VW bus, and just to give you the picture what it's like to drive one of those, after that very thin sheet metal that appears to be a front end, then you have about an eighth inch of cardboard, some air, and then your knees. And that, your knees are the 5 mile an hour bumper on that car.
A lot of people say that the 67 was one of the best years for the Beetle because it still had the classic bumpers and the classic seats and the classic lights, but it had the 12-volt electrical system and a better engine. 68, they changed the styling a little bit. A lot of people really value the 67.
Yeah, yeah, this is pre the Super Beetle.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. When they put the tail lights and all that got bigger, yeah. I agree. This is the car that a lot of people grew up with.
Yep.
Including myself. And she's got the fan in there. Using that for her. You know, we used to drive cars like that all the time. You're not thinking about it.
Yeah, now it's like, oh my gosh, it's over
80. Wow, check this out.
Right here, better.
Oh, this is the Morgan class, okay. This is, I didn't know we had transitioned already. Third, people's choice. This is the 1962 Morgan, plus four, Robert Abraham. And, you know, Morgans have a lot of wood in them, right? They, as we know. Yeah, a lot of wood. The wood that you did not like a woody, but you see the wood. Yeah, this is all hidden. And they still build a Morgan. Today, with wood.
Yep.
Because it's a limited production, they get around a lot of wood. that was the people's choice right there, ladies and gentlemen. That was the choice. Okay, the third place car is a 1999 Morgan Plus 8, owned by Alan Schwartz. And I love the color combination here. And, it's, you know, the roof is almost looks like it's chopped. You know, it looks like it's been shortened. Like a custom. Yeah. And not one spare tire. Two spare tires. So you can not only have bad luck, you can have the best. Second place, Ford Oregon. Now that last one was a 1999.
Yeah, I know. It's
that's a new car.
Talk about a classic.
Here's a 1954. This is a plus four, two-seater, owned by Creighton Turner. And you love the convertible rollback top and everything. The color, I love the color. The black wheels, they're very, very pleasing. And I might add that that white dress is perfect for that car. Was that first place? Michael Haddam. Okay, that's first place. Yep. Sorry about that, Michael. You're first place.
1973. We have a special award for our third place car, Best Paint and Finish Award. And it's also third place. It's a 1974 BMW 3.0 CSL owned by Ron Perry.
Boy, I'll tell you, this car has wings and design. The rear vertical stabilizers for the wings, the fins, the front fender fins.
This is also getting best paint and finish if we haven't already.
Oh, it is. Okay.
Best paint and finish if we have that award.
It's got a speed stripe down the top of the trim line. It's got a speed stripe on the front air dam. I mean, what is this? This is 70 something?
Did we already give him the best paint and finish award? Did he have that?
Yes. He did get that.
Yes.
They didn't get it. Well, you didn't get
it.
We
need to give this car the best paint and finish award. Best paint and finish. We'll see. So we gotta wait one more award. Best paint and finish.
If you know the 70s, this car has 70s written all over it.
Oh, absolutely. On the way to Studio 54, this bad boy, the platform.
Good.
All right. Our second place car in BMW 1973 is a 1971 BMW V25 owned by Ben Miller. Now this was always kind of a hot car. This was the racing version of the CS series, aka the
Backbone. Boy, that's a nice one.
And I believe that color is called Golf Yellow. He's got a matching polo shirt to go with it.
Look at the wheels. The wheels are themselves.
Well, that's the RPS. This is our first place car.
You guys take a moment.
This is our first place car.
You know, when you look at these cars for the people who are here today, when you look at that belt line that goes around, that is a tough thing for
you. Oh, you get it right? Absolutely.
It's something that was so easily put on at the back.
Also,
the wheel arch trim.
And notice the green, what we call the greenhouse. It's the glass area for this car. You know, cars didn't have right mirrors back then. You didn't really need it. I mean, you could just look over your shoulder.
The rear quarter windows are huge on this car, aren't they? Okay, next class is Jaguar XKE, or Jaguar. Jaguar.
Or as they say in the South, Jaguar.
Yeah, XKE through 1967. Of course, the XKE is a one-of-a-kind sports car. This is a 1973 Jaguar XKE owned by Ray Lewis. 1973. You notice there's no glass over the front headlights, just the chrome trim around the carved out area where the headlight is. Great car, beautiful car. Our first place winner is a 1960. You should be able to see the difference. See the glass over the headlights now? This is the way they started. See how the grille is? It's got that rolled edge to the inlet.
And more common to find authentic knockoff wire wheels on early cars.
Right. The earlier cars are a little bit more bulbous, maybe a little bit more sexy in their curves. And again, this is an XKE Roadster owned by Brad Woods. Both of them black, interestingly enough.
Not an easy car to restore well. Our third place car is a 1965 Sunbeam Tiger, owned by Stephen Alcala. Talk about a sleeper, because, you know, unmodified like that with the factory wheel covers. This was a Sunbeam Alpine. Real Shelby had a little help. With the Cobra. They stuffed the Ford small block in it, but you wouldn't almost know it to look at it. It just looked like a little British sports car until you hit the gas pedal and fired up that V8. So, congratulations on third place. Our second place car is also getting the Pasadena Society Award and second place for 1953 Aston Martin, owned by David Martin. Pasadena Humane Society Award,
beautiful car there. What a grill on that car. What a color.
Very nice.
That car has that arch to it.
Yeah.
It gives you a feeling of
Design. Would you call that pistachio?
Yeah.
We have the Pasadena Humane Society. Are they going to present their award for this class? Hold on a second. I want to make sure you get your other award, too. Pasadena Humane, do we have that award?
Yes.
We already got it. Okay, got it. Thank you very much.
I want to know who gets the inhumane.
I want to know who decided that they didn't need to have speakers up there on the ramp. All right, here comes British sports cars. First place winner, 1962 Triumph Italia.
That's the winner.
Opener.
I'm sorry.
Triumph, the Italian design. Michelotti helped him with both the TR4 and the TR6. This is called the Italia, a closed car, unlike most Triumphs of the era, which is open cars like the TR2, TR3, TR4, and so forth. Very nice.
You know what? Every single one of these cars that's come across here, it's obvious why they're getting awards. They're all perfect cars.
You bet. Especially staying over the sun. I mean, they might have been in the shade when they were done.
Here's a classic. This is the Jaguar XK120 class, XK140 and XK150, all in this class. Third place is the 1957 Jaguar XKE140, owned by Peter Mullen. The 140, the 120 are very popular to be used as race cars. It was the type of car back in the 50s. That you could literally drive to the racetrack, like Laguna Seca or somewhere, Riverside. Exactly. Riverside, first race, 1957. So that's the cars we're talking here. This is second place. It's a 1956 Jaguar XK140, owned by Randy Simon and Sharon Schwartz. And again, a really, really beautiful, understated color. Just very elegant, and the wheels being the same color. And a really off-white, great-looking top that goes with that. First place is a 1956, same year as the car leading the Jaguar XK140. Yes. Owned by Robert Huntington. Now this particular car, what I love about these is the way the upholstery wraps over the edge of the cockpit. You would see this on like the Marchetta Ferrari.
You have a place to rest your arm. You're relaxing a little bit, you put your left arm there.
It just really finishes the cockpit.
Really nice, and it tells you right away what color the interior is.
Right, right. Yeah, I always love that little finish work on those. It's got a lay down windshield. In hot rodding, they call that a Duval windshield. You see those on boats where you have a lay down windshield.
All right, the next category is one of my favorite Corvettes. The split window, the Corvette Coupe, owned by Robert Morapolo. This was the new Stingray for 1963. Talk about a design departure. Talk about a car that looked like it was right out of the future. We've got a fuel here, and the fuel injected small blockade, and that one-year-old split rear window in 1964, they eliminated the center portion into one-piece glass. The guys actually used the window.
This blue, I think, it was a pretty popular color.
Is that Marina blue? Is that Marina blue? Yeah, it's been Marina blue, maybe?
Yeah, that was a pretty popular. It's got the red stripe tires on it.
All right.
Extra cost.
And here comes our first place winner in Corvette for 1970.
Harry Lemitas. Got the side pipes on it.
Yeah.
This is third place. This is a 32 Ford Roadster pickup. Yeah, that's a rare car. And that's by Gary DeMond.
That ain't fiberglass. Steel body.
They made less pickups than they did Roadsters. That's right. And then look,
talk about a fetish here. The Halibrand wheels and the pine crust.
The key kidney bean wheels.
Yep. Halibrand.
Yeah, those are the real deal. They've been finished in the gold finish. It's really, really good. What it takes to be done. Thank you.